A couple of old English common law terms that you will need to know so you can pass your real estate licensing exam. All of that in this video. Hey everyone, my name is Paul Vojchehoske and I'm the director of Randall School of Real Estate, and welcome to our YouTube channel. So in this video, there are two common Old English common law terms that you have to know for your real estate licensing exam, the allodial system and the feudal system. And we're going to discuss both of those in today's video.
So the evolution of land ownership, we have to discuss that because there's a couple of key terms, as you can see on your screen, that we need to know. And notice it says feudal system, allodial system, and land patent, and all of them have a yellow highlight with them. I've highlighted the key terms that you really need to know in the PowerPoint presentation. So, and that'll be throughout the entire course as well. So a feudal system, prior to July 4, 1776, we belonged to the king. We had the 13 colonies. The king owned everything. He assigned governors and mayors, and he placed leadership in place. The king owned everything. There was no such thing as private ownership. Well, when we gained our independence, we had a problem because we went from the king owning everything to now, does the government own it? Is there going to be private ownership? And it was something that was a topic that was actually debated in the Continental Congress. Ultimately, we chose what was called the allodial system. And the allodial system is where we have individual ownership. The government doesn't own anything. And in fact, it's a right of ownership without any government interference whatsoever. That means it gives us, the individual owner, the right to buy property, sell property, exchange it, lease it out, have its subsurface rights, the air rights, and it also gives us the ability to bequeath our properties to our heirs or someone else. And the term bequeath or bequeathed simply means that you will your property to somebody. But the government in early American history did own some property. In fact, we had the original 13 colonies, and then in 1803, the government purchased the Louisiana Purchase from France. This was all government-owned property. However, our Constitution and the way that our form of government was designed is the government doesn't own land. Not originally, back then. Things have changed, and we're going to talk about that a little bit later. But the government wanted the people to expand, and so the land that they bought in the Louisiana Purchase, they gave to settlers. And they gave the settlers, let's say, 50 acres in let's say, Arkansas, for example. Well, what happened is that they had to prove, how do we prove that the government gave me 50 acres in Arkansas? Well, they did it by what was called a land patent. And I like to refer to this as the property's original birth certificate, if you will. Now, today we transfer title or ownership to property using a deed, and we're going to talk about that in chapter 4. But back then we used a land patent. That was the original birth certificate of that property, transferring ownership from the government to the settlers. All right, turn to page 16, and you'll notice that on page 16, midway through, is where, in blue bold print there, is where the term land patent is.
That's all I got for today's video. Don't forget, another video right here. It'll help you with studying. Over here, the little circle. If you have not subscribed to the channel yet, click on that little circle. I will see you in the next video.